You're gonna have
to. But yeah, it's about to be.
Yeah, 10:40. Sandra.
So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. But again, hi everyone. I hope everyone is having a wonderful week, and I really appreciate all the birthday wishes. And again, I wouldn't be here today without you guys, your support and all of your feedback. So thank you very much. So gift for you guys today for that, we'll be going over some apps that I think would really improve, you know, because we're just hit spring. It felt like winter was forever, right?
Yeah.
So this will help you with spring cleaning, your mind, your brain, your soul. So let's go ahead and get started. We have, you know, of course, we're going to do tutorials. We have a video and just discussion. I love hearing you guys' thoughts and feedback on what we talk about. So again, just be mindful of your TVs, your cell phones. And if you use the chat to put a question, I'll be able to look at it while I present and may answer it during. But again, we have quite a bit to go through today. So just please save any questions you have until the end, unless you would like to put it in the chat. But yes, so today, we will be going over what is spring. Of course, it's always good to have a little biography or a little background on what we're doing today. So we're gonna go over some fun facts and the meaning of spring. I'm gonna introduce to you guys three apps. One is called WikiHow, which is, you can look up guides on anything. Refind is a brain or a knowledge app where they curate special articles for you based on your interests. And the New York Times crossword. So it's a app with a bunch of games provided from the New York Times that also stimulate your brain. So we'll be going over all of that through the app navigation and the information about the apps. And of course, we're gonna have an overview and a discussion. So you can ask me any questions, ask me to go over anything and what you think of the apps. So let's go ahead and get started. So first, we're gonna talk about what is spring, again, fun facts, and the meaning of spring. So I found this wonderful video that we're gonna watch that talks about spring, how it started, and when it actually starts, because that's a question many have. So I'm gonna go ahead and expand this for you guys.
The thing that's different about a Vrbo vacation home? You always have the whole place to yourself.
You guys can see and hear everything, right?
Spring. We all love spring. But do we know when it really starts? Do you know there are at least three ways to define spring? First of all, many people think spring is the months of March, April, and May. This concept began in 1780 when an international organization for meteorology defined the seasons as groupings of three whole months of the Gregorian calendar. Ever since then, professional meteorologists have used this definition, which makes spring start on March 1st in the Northern Hemisphere. However, astronomers hold a different view. They say the equinox in March marks the beginning of spring. That happens to match the Persian definition of spring, and that's why Persian New Year starts with the spring equinox. You may be surprised that ancient Chinese discovered the spring equinox thousands of years ago. They just didn't see it as the onset of spring. Instead, they regarded it as the midpoint of spring, and they were not alone. In medieval Europe, the equinox in March was also considered the midpoint of spring. The old definition is actually more scientific than you may think. It's based on the concept that the summer solstice, the day that gets the longest sunlight of the year, should be the peak of summer. And if a season is about 12 weeks long, the beginning of summer should be about 6 weeks ahead of the summer solstice. That's in early May. As a matter of fact, May was a summer month in William Shakespeare's time. Remember the first four lines of his sonnet 18? Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's leaves have all too short a date. See, if May is a summer month, that makes February a spring month. No wonder Carnival falls in February most of the time, and so does Chinese Lunar New Year. That's why Lunar New Year is called the Spring Festival in Chinese. Believe it or not, many Chinese Americans, including myself, didn't even know that. We grew up westernized, so we only knew the modern definitions of the four seasons in the West. We might have been confused by whether spring should start on March 1st or March 20th, but we never thought spring could start in February. Some people may argue that February is too cold to be spring. That's true, because there is something called thermal lag. It's like boiling a pot of water. It takes time to warm up or cool down. No wonder modern scientists define the four seasons based on temperatures and how people feel about the weather. That's a human-centric approach, as opposed to the nature-centric view in ancient China and medieval Europe. Now we understand there are different definitions of spring, just as there are different opinions on everything else. Learning about various points of view always broadens our horizons. That's the beauty of our multicultural society.
Wow, that was very interesting and a lot of cool little fun facts that I was not aware of. So I thought, hope that was useful for you all. But like she said, on 2023, the first day of spring was March 20th, so Monday. It's also known as the spring equinox, and this occurs when the sun will be moving directly over the Earth's equator. So in some years it's the 19th, some years is the 20th, some years is the 21st. You know, again, just like a year can be slightly different from 365 days, the spring season can start at a different time or a day each year. So it all depends on, you know, the climate and what's going on. But generally that period of time is when the sun will be moving directly over the Earth's equator.
One very specific is to definitely put all your Reese's eggs in one.
Again, please be mindful of your TVs and your phones. Thank you very much. Some fun facts about spring. One, in many cultures around the world, spring is considered a time of rebirth and renewal. Some major holidays, including Easter and Passover, are timed to be celebrated after the spring equinox, so after the first day of spring. Also, research suggests that for many people, the extended daylight also boosts mood, well-being, and energy. One theory is that dopamine, a chemical messenger that promotes pleasure, motivation, confidence, and memory, it increases with more exposure to sunlight. People tend to be more curious and creative and use their natural instincts to figure things out and to push boundaries, which allows them to challenge themselves to take on more independent tasks. So what it's saying is this is the perfect time to start something new, to start with the, a new year, a fresh mindset, to improve, not just your body, but your brain as well, and how you interact and with other folks and other people. So again, that's why we're going to go over some apps that help with your brain, but also your state of mind. So again, we're going to go over three apps today. WikiHow, Refind, and the New York Times crossword. So again, if you guys have any questions about these apps, please put them in the chat and I can answer them throughout the session if they are appropriate. But first, we are gonna talk about WikiHow, Learn How to Do Anything. The WikiHow app gives you over 150,000 how-to guides right in the palm of your hand to read or watch step-by-step instructions on every imaginable topic. Become the DIY, do-it-yourself, master of anything. You're able to bookmark articles to read and use later, read featured articles of the day, browse random guides for your entertainment, and much more. So if you go to your app store, and of course, just like any other app, you use the search at the bottom to search for the WikiHow app. So when you search WikiHow, on the right side, you'll see the app, make sure it says WikiHow, and then you're able to download and install it, okay? So that is the WikiHow app. In the app, this is what your home screen is gonna look like. It's very simple app to navigate. On the top left is the menu button, so you can see featured and random guides. You can view your bookmarks, which articles you've saved, and access survival kit guides, which are really interesting and important. And then on the top right is the search button. So you can search for all types of guides based on your interests. So it's very simple. The home screen features some articles, and on the left, you can access more, and on the right, you can search for them. So if we go to the WikiHow app, you can have all of our apps downloaded that we've went over so far in this screen. So let's open the WikiHow app. So look, you can, there are some featured articles like how to log out of Netflix, how to cook boneless turkey breast, how to stop a dog from jumping, how to measure in inches, et cetera. So goes on and on and on. On the top left is the menu button. Again, you can see the featured articles. So that's the very first thing that you see when you open the app. You can view a random guide. So if I hit random, look, how to make cream eyeshadow. So it gives you a synopsis and then the method, an actual method, and then you can actually complete the steps as soon as you finish each one. So look, I finished that step, go to number two, finish that step. And look, they even give little videos or little images that help you figure out what to do. Complete that and et cetera. So you go through the guide, and you can also, it also gives you warnings and things you need, tips, related guides that you can look at, and the references too. So you can actually look at where WikiHow got their resources from, and you could look at and at that to see more of the original source material. But again, the guide is very useful for a lot of different things. Again, at the bottom left, you can bookmark this article to save for later. See, it has a little check mark, and then you can share it. So hey, if you think this guide will be useful to a friend or family member, you can hit share. And then you can email it to someone. You can iMessage. If you have iMessage enabled, you can copy the link. You can open them in Safari and other things. So it's very convenient to share it with, again, friends and family. If you go back to the menu, if you hit bookmarks, the one that we just bookmarked, it appears right here. So that way I could look at it later. And last but not least is a survival kit. So if I hit that, look, animal attacks, CPR, escapes, first aid, home emergencies, natural disasters. Definitely the natural disasters will, you know, as the earth ages on, that will become more prevalent. So let's go here. How to prepare for a hurricane, how to prepare for a tornado, how to prepare for a wildfire, how to protect yourself in a thunderstorm, things like that is very useful and pertinent. So I would definitely just look through and see which ones you may need help with, like self-defense. Who doesn't need help with self-defense? How to avoid being mugged, how to be confident and safe from going out alone, how to be street smart, things like that. So things that are very relevant to our world today. I would explore that and use the search to search for anything. So if someone could unmute and suggest something we search on how to do, I would really appreciate that. Anyone have a suggestion?
Knitting.
Okay, how to knit. Thank you so much, Anne. How to knit. Look, I do that, all these different results pop up. Knit sockets, knit blanks. How to knit the knit stitch, knit for kids, knit a beanie, all of that. So if you hit the first one, how to knit. Again, a little synopsis, things you should know, and the method. So you can literally learn how to do anything pretty much through this app. And it might save you some dollars because if you can figure out how to do something yourself instead of, calling someone and having, to pay them, you could pay yourself by learning the whatever you may need to learn. But look, this is so cool. They actually show you the moving image of what to do. So this is what you do, Anne, right? When you knit, you are doing the images or the moving images that you see on how to thread and how to get the string right. So isn't that pretty cool? Literally anything, how to start a campfire, anything.
You can
Look,
survive. Yes.
start a campfire. And you can read, prepare and build a fire. Make sure you can legally build. So it gives you a lot of great tips on whatever you want to do. And
But
look at these
Alex,
videos.
does it take up a lot of storage on your storage, available storage, this app? Because that's the
No.
problem I've been having with downloading apps. They take up so much storage.
Yeah, so different these apps, no, a lot of the apps that take a lot of storage, some of them are like pre-built, like GarageBand and such. But I would suggest you look into the iCloud Plus subscription, Yvonne, so that way you can have more places, more storage in the cloud and less on your iPad, so you don't have to worry about particular storage, okay?
All right, thank you.
But yeah, this is the WikiHow app. You can search for anything, and they're great little guides, and it's very easy to navigate. So next up, we are going to go over. Oops. Give me a second. But yeah, while you wait in your head, just think of what you can, what you need to learn how to do, and you could search it up. The next app we're going to go over is called Refind. Get smarter every day. The Refind app chooses five hand-picked links from around the web that makes you smarter and tailored to your interest. So some benefits include there are new articles every day. You'll be getting it as a notification and an email. The app also learns. The more you interact, the better your picks will become. You can customize your interest. And there have been over 200,000 lifelong learners that start their day with Refind. That learn from reading all the articles that they provide every day that, again, are tailored to your interest. So first, you're going to sign up. So it'll look like the image on the right. When you open the app, all you got to do is type in your email. If you want to see how the app looks first before you sign up, you can hit let me see it first and look at that. But it's very simple to type your email. You don't even need a password for this. You just need to type in your email. Once you type in your email, you're going to get a verification code sent to your email, again, making sure that it's you. And the email will look like what's on the left. It'll have the code. So you make sure you put in that code to the back into the Refind app, and then you will choose your topics, which you can see on the right. So when you choose your topics and you have everything set up, your app will look like, oops, it will look like this, where this will be your home screen. So we're gonna again go to the App Store. This is where you find all of the apps that we go over today. You hit search and then you type in Refind. Not Refind like R-E-F-I-N-E-D, but Refind, R-E-F-I-N-D. Get smarter every day. You see it's on the very right. And again, download and install it. So we're gonna go ahead and open the app. Look, get smarter every day. Every day we pick 5 articles that make you smarter, tailored to your interests. So all you gotta do is type in your email. Again, if you wanna see it first, you hit let me see it first. And again, it picks 5 links for you, but of course you haven't picked your interests. So it's just picking some random apps, but this is what essentially you will receive. But again, it's very easy just to type in your email. So I have a test email for you guys that I use. I'm gonna go ahead and type it in, whatever email that's on your iPad, that's the easiest to put in. So I'll put in my email, I hit subscribe. It says verify your email. We sent a 6-digit verification code to that email. So of course you go to your mail app and you find that email with the verification code. So I hit the home button, go to my mail app and open my email. So you see Refind right here. And then the code is right there. Very simple. Enter this code into the window where you began logging into your Refind account. So we're gonna go back to the Refind app and enter those numbers, 634-913. 634-913, and then confirm. There you go. Every day we pick 5 links that make you smarter, pick your favorite topics. So there's quite a few of them to look through. Just make sure you pick at least 3. So for me, I like culture, I like gaming, I like art, music, for society, I like equity and inclusion. I like reading about nature and the economy, the future, whatever you like. Tech, of course, a lot about the industry, finance, business. I like science, physics, and math, so I'll do all of that. And then this is just life. So food, mental health, better living, mindfulness, sleep is very important. So whatever you like, career, and I like US programming, data visualization, data science, whatever tickles your fancy. So I picked my links. At the bottom right is the continue button. So once I hit that, it's matching links with my interests. And look, we picked 5 links for you, which look interesting. So for me, the cause of depression, that's interesting, pasta. Maybe this one on data I like. It just says select all links that look interesting to you. So whatever is interesting to you, make sure you pick it. And then hit finish. Look, start that habit. Great, you seem to like some of these links. Every day we pick 5 new links for you. The more you interact, the better your picks become. So I want these picks to be delivered, let's see, maybe 12:30. I usually have lunch then, so I can take some time and read some articles and make sure that you turn on your notifications. So at that time every day, you will receive those links to you in a notification. So turn on notifications. Yep, we'd like to send you notifications, allow. And there you go, you hit start. So again, every day at whatever time you select, you will receive 5 links catered to you. So look, we're in the homepage now. Every day at 12:30, we pick 5 links for you. Here are today's picks. So you see rhythm in plant cells. That's cool. So if I wanted to open it, I just open the article and then takes me right here to the site, and I can now go ahead and read it or look at it. So this is a visualization, rhythm in plant cells. So if you look at the data, that's pretty cool. Different plants have different electrical rhythms. So that's something I really like biology when in high school. So this is something again that I would be interested in. So if you go back, you see there's the bookmark option. So if I want to save it for later, I can save it to my reading list. And yeah, this one made me smarter because it taught me something I didn't know. So I want to make sure I hit made me smarter. And look, there are other articles as well. There are some from the archives. Did I like today's links? And then look, there's are something called deep dives. So you can go deeper into a particular topic. So look, the history of food. There are different things you can subscribe where every day you'll receive something regarding that topic. But yeah, this is the home screen. So at the bottom is the today button. You can view your 5 curated links and other articles. On the reading list button right next to it, you can save articles from the Refined or the Safari app, which is really cool. I'm gonna go ahead and showcase that in a minute. Next is the library button. So you can view and create collections of different articles. And last but not least is the explore button. So you can browse trending and recommended articles based on your interests and choose different publications to follow. So again, if you go back to the Refined app, and you see today, again, there are different articles that you can access, things of that nature. The reading list, again, you can view all of the different articles that you have bookmarked, and you can actually bookmark them from the Safari app as well, because that's where they're getting all of these articles from the internet. So if you find one that you're reading in Safari, you can actually save it in this app. So if I go to my Safari app, oops, and then let's see, let me search for an article, news articles about spring. So if I type that in, and look, the first one is from CNN. Cool, I may not have time right now to read it, but I can sure save it. And you can actually save it inside of your Refined app. So normally, you know, for anything in Safari, you can add it as a bookmark and save it for later. But look, if you look right in the middle, when you hit the share button in Safari, you should see the Refined option. So if I hit Refined, look, save to Refined. You could save it to your reading list or another list that made me smarter list. So I'm going to save it to my reading list. So I hit save and bam. If I go back to my Refined app, and go to my reading list. Here it goes. You see at the top left, there are different options. The Read Next, I'm assuming these are the articles directly from Refined. And then if you hit Full List, look, again, that CNN article is saved right here. So that way I could just access the Refined app and read another article and have this one ready to go in case I would like to read it. So that is the Reading List button. Read Next, Full List at the top. The library, of course, you can view different lists or create your own collection of links. So for the Made Me Smarter, look, Made Me Smarter, that article we saved earlier and I had marked it as that, it appears right here. If I go back to Recently Opened, same thing. If I want to create a collection, I can sure do that. I can add a link. And add links from the web to a certain collection. So it's all up to how you want to organize your links. And last but not least is the explore option. So look, trending articles, stuff that is relevant today. The next is because you liked that certain article, it gives you other articles. And look, all the topics that I selected beforehand, it appears right here with different articles as well. So UX, career, sleep, mindfulness, better leave-in, mental health, et cetera. Even about math. It's just pretty amazing. All this different information is right here. And if you look at the top right, when you hit the explore, you can search. So you can search for based by topic, of course, or you could probably search by name. So let me type in spring. Let me see what that does. There is a premium option for different things, but I really haven't found a use for some of it yet. So that search feature, unfortunately, you'll have to use it through their premium service if you would like to get access to it. So some things you may not be able to search, but there are paid options as well. So you can pay monthly, yearly, or lifetime. Or if you share this app with a certain amount of friends, you can get the premium option free for a year. And at 20 referrals, you can get the option for free forever. So some of them, like ad free, the library, they have audio options as well. So that's if you would like to get the premium option. But as far as I use it, it's A-okay just to read the curated ones to you every day. It's very simple, just take about 10 to 15 minutes of your day to look through. But it's a lot of wonderful and useful information with the Refined app. Last but not least, we are going to go over in a second the New York Times crosswords. So you can play Wordle, Sudoku, and more. So keep your mind sharp with word, number, and logic puzzles with the New York Times crossword app. Free to download, the app offers new puzzles daily for every skill level. So you have, of course, the crossword. It's, you know, a classic word game, and there's a new one daily, and there's a mini crossword. So it has simple clues and it's easier to finish. You can play Wordle. So see if you can guess the 5-letter word in 6 tries or less. So if any of you are on Facebook, you may see people share that they took 4 or 3 tries with figuring out the word. So you may see that. And of course there's Sudoku and more. When you open the app, it'll look like on the left, where you can create an account if you so choose, if you want to check stats and compete with friends and things like that, if you want to, but you can start or play without an account. And then when you open the app, you will have a free trial for everything. So on the right, you can see that you have a free trial for accessing everything and the archives as well. So I would take advantage of that when you download the app. And of course, some of the features are under a subscription. But in essence, you can, if you don't want all of the archives, all the previous things of that nature, you can just stick with it for free. So again, on the left is what your app will look like with the different navigation buttons at the bottom and the home screen. And then if you would like to access all of the games and all of the archives for the games, it's either $40 a year or $5 a month. Again, when you open the New York Times crossword app, you'll have the games and the packs button at the bottom where you can view all of your games and different crossword puzzles available. And then on the bottom right, you'll have the archives, the stats, and the leaderboard button. So all of these either require an account or a subscription to access. particularly the stats and the leaderboard, if you want to see like your friends and their progress, you could do that. And then the archives button, it requires that subscription so you can play previously uploaded games. Again, you go to the app store, just as usual, and then you go in and search, and you search for the New York Times crossword. Once you do that, on the right, the app will open up, and you can download and install it, just like the other two apps. So let's go ahead and open and play some games, right? So when you open it, again, because I downloaded previously, my free trial ended. But yeah, if you'd like to know the moment puzzles are available, please opt in by allowing notifications. So yes, anytime a new game is available, it'll send you a notification. So you see my trial is ended, but look, in the game section, you have a lot of free packs available to play. Some latest packs are available that you may have to pay for, but you can try them. You can try one puzzle from each theme. So that's what I did when I first got the app a couple of years ago. I just went through all the packs and played what I could. And since then, they've added different games. So first, we're going to start off with the daily mini. So again, every day, you'll receive a new daily mini. So if you don't pay for a subscription, you're only to pay for that day. As you can see, all the puzzles previously are locked until I pay for that subscription. So you see for the games only, it's $4.99 a month or $40 a year if you would like access to all of the games. But first, let's play today's crossword. So I would love some help with this. So let's do today's daily mini. You can hold it either way. They actually just updated. I have not seen this format before, so I think this is really wonderful and cute. So let's see. Season two. Season two of what? I don't know what that is. So let's go to the next one. Yippee. I don't know that off the top of my head.
Will season two be summer?
Some S-U-M-M-E-R. Uh-huh. It could be.
Season two, the first one.
Yeah.
Season two?
Would that summer. Be summer?
Summer. Try summer.
Okay. The great thing is you can always edit your response. So summer fits because that's a six-letter word. This one is a fleet of warships. Does anyone know what a fleet of warships is?
Exchange.
I don't know the name for it.
Fleet of warships. Fleet of warships.
So yeah, if you get stuck, you can, you know, you see all the clues. So look, stupid is as stupid blank. So stupid, I'm assuming that's like stupid. Yes. Stupid. Like, I think it's
does.
Yes. Does. That's yeah. Good as well. I didn't think of that. So now we're on down. So let's exchange.
Swap. What is swap?
Good. Good job, Dolores. studied carefully with over.
Understood.
Under.
Okay, so if this is under right here, then it cannot be does if it's under. So
it cannot be does. U-N-D-E-R, that's under.
Right, but if that you put R, work. The R is where the D goes, right?
U-N-D-E-R.
Right, but the R is with the D. You see, we already have does Yippee. Here.
Whoopi is number two, 7. Yippee
U-N-D.
Is.
U-N-D-E-R.
Okay.
Number one across is spring.
Yeah. Well, it can't be spring because that's not enough letters. That's S P R I N G. Well, that works too. Let's see if spring works because you think when you think winter.
Yeah, spring. Okay. Let's see.
I don't know because it's a season.
Studied,
With the first season, in the first season.
Well, well, that's the whole thing. You gotta use the brain because you can't. Well, you can think of it as season, like the season of the like winter or spring, or you could think of like season as TV. So what I do is I usually look for easy.
Oh, you right.
Look for easy
Romeo.
Too.
Oh, she right.
Romeo.
You know, three down.
That makes sense, Romeo.
Number four down is I have.
Yes, good job, Violet. I thought of that as well. So look, you see we have the puzzle more than halfway filled. So that way, if you go back to seven across, like Dan said, it looks like Roo.
Whoopie.
Five is north. And six is grow.
North branching out points. Good job. North. R-T-H. Egg on. What does egg on mean?
Go.
Do it. Maybe do it too.
I forgot what you call that.
But you see how the letters are kind of
egg on is gold. Goat. Gold.
G-O-A-D.
I'm in class.
Gold.
G-O-R-D.
G-O-A-D.
You gotta get two.
I don't know. That's what I
I didn't say gold. I said gold.
Gold.
G-O-R-D.
G-O-A-D.
G-O-A-D.
Okay, oh, it has to be, oh, if this is woohoo, then it has to be G-O something, right?
A-D. I said R-D, but I may not
said
be gotten it right.
It's A-D.
Goad somebody.
G-O-A-D.
When you goad somebody into doing something.
Uh-huh. Okay, yes. Okay.
That's
so,
what I said.
As you can see right here, it has to be this word right here. So north was a good suggestion, this one is peeved. Nine across is peeved. Yes, that makes it annoyed.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Number five down is.
Fleet of warship is Armada.
Good job.
Oh,
yes.
Oh, my. Yes.
Whoever said that, good job. Yeah. And then look. Woohoo. Look. What? And look. Woohoo. Woo. Nodes. Branching out points. Nodes. Congratulations. There you go. We solved it together. So you see, it takes a lot of logic and thinking, because when you have other clues, you can use those letters to help solve other clues. So we started with summer. We realized summer did not work. So we went to spring, and you see how everything kind of fell into place. And words like Armada, like, you got to think on that. So when you see more of the letters, it really helps figuring out the next one. So yes, so that was an example of today's session. So that's the daily mini. So now let's play some Wordle. So you got to figure out the word with get six chances to get a five letter word. So we're going to play that. So it could be anything. Yeah. So look, the green one is the word, and is the letter is in the correct spot. The yellow means it's the letter's in the word, but it's the wrong spot. And the gray means that the letter is not in any spot. So if you guys have seen Lingo on Game Show Network way back in the day, this is basically Lingo. So
You went too fast on that rules.
Yeah. So we'll learn more as we play. So who would like to suggest a word to start off with?
Oh, the letters at the bottom. Oh, okay.
Yeah, so pick a word. You're trying to figure out the five letter word. So who has the five letter word that they want to try?
Queer. Q-U-E-E-R. Queer.
Okay. So we do that and then hit the enter. So look, the U is in the right place and the E is in the right place.
And the E is
so
in
good
the
job.
Right.
So the U and so what do green stand for?
It means green means it's in the right. It's in the right spot, and it's in the letter.
Okay.
So what you
and
can
then
either,
the other three aren't in the word at all.
No. So that's why they have the keyboard also highlighted as well. So Yeah, so for the next line, either you can try a word with U as a second
letter
or as the fourth letter, or you can try another completely different word with letters you haven't used in order to see if they're in the puzzle, for example. So one word that
quiet.
I look
what
at.
What about quiet?
No,
but Q is not in it.
We could do that.
Q is not in it.
Do that, but that wouldn't be a best use
of the letters.
Oh, that's right.
You say Q isn't in it.
Yeah, gray meaning is not in there. That's the gray meaning.
Oh,
what about guilt?
Okay, that's a good word because that's uses one of the letters that we already have, so we can figure out the other letters. So look, guilt. I hit enter.
Okay,
so it's U.
So we got U,
E-T. So it's U and then E-T in those spots.
Okay. So U.
U, E-T.
What about sugar?
Okay, good. That's a good word.
S-U-G-A-R, but we won't get
it right. Right, we already know
the U. Yeah, but the T, because we know the T is at the end.
Right, you want to see if R is anywhere else in the word. So if we hit enter, look,
you got that.
So we know that,
that U is in the right place.
Yeah.
So the U and the E is in the right place.
The words that have a U in the second place and the ET at the end.
So try to think of a word with all of the unused letters so it will let us know if we have a certain place. So look at all of the unused letters and see if you can find a word so we can learn more information.
Something. What about putty? P-U-T-T-Y.
No, it gotta be a T.
No.
Yeah,
yeah.
It is a T.
You got the right idea, but we wanna make sure we use as least already used letters as possible.
We need the first, the third, and
so
the left.
anything with the O, let's see if O is in the puzzle. So try
what
to find a word with the letter O.
Like a duvet that covers the comforter, D-U-V-E-T, right?
Okay, duvet, let's see if that works.
Yeah, duvet.
Oh, there you go.
There it is.
And we got it for a try.
Yes, it is.
Hey.
Sorry, make sure your TVs and stuff are off, please. Thank you so much. So, but yeah, good job. That was Louise.
Yeah,
I know that. I couldn't even think of that word. So yes, good job, Louise. But that's, you guys get the general idea. You just use the words and the letters that you know, and you could use it to figure the next word out. So for any of these games, at the top right, you can see the little question mark so you can learn how to play a certain game. So last but not least, let's play some Sudoku. So
I'm not good at that.
I used to play this years ago.
So try this numbers game minus the map. So let's play an easy
Sudoku.
Yeah. All of the numbers have to every column has to be different. And all of the numbers in each of the 9 square boxes have to be different as well. So for example, you see at the top left box, you see there only is 2 numbers left, 1 and 4. So you see 1 is already here in this column, so it has to go in the middle. And because there's only 1 more left, it has to be 4.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, same idea with the 1 on the first column. There's 1, 4, and 9. So if I look at 1 cannot be in the second box on the left, it has to be at the bottom because there's already a 1 in there.
Because there's one, okay.
Mm-hmm. Two can go there, and two can go there.
Yeah, so that's-
You know how I play mine, Alex, too? For the second box coming down, you see the 2 nines on each of the other boxes?
Yes, 2 nines, so it has to be right here.
Right.
In the middle.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Right. So yeah, each row of 3, you can look at all the numbers and each of them have to be in a different row and a different columns. So look, yeah. Nine's here, nine's here, nine has
to be.
Oh, you
going there?
Here.
It
has to be in the middle.
Yeah.
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 So,
in the third box. Yeah, I see which. Yes.
Mm-hmm. So that's.
Thing gotta be 1 through 9 in each box.
Yes.
And, so that last corner, it had that one would be right
yes.
there.
Yeah, it has to be one right here because four is here. So four has to be here. And then look, if you look at this box, you need 3 and you need 6. So because 3 is already here in this row, it has to go here. And therefore 6 has to be here.
Oh, okay.
And then if you look at if you look at
wait,
this
wait, hold
row,
on. I'm going too fast.
1, 2, 3, 4. So you need 5 and 7. So for here, we don't know that in particular, so we move on to the next row. So for this, you have 1, 2, 3, you need 4 in here, you need 4 and you need 8. So look, 4 is right
four
here.
4 can't go there, 4 has to go down. Right,
it has to go right here, yep. And because there's only one more row left, that's that has to be the last number. So it's 8. So look, with that, we have 2 more box spaces left in this box. So 1, 2, 3, 4, we need 5 and 7. So, we don't know that. So we got to move on to the next line. So you just keep going forward and figuring out. Look, so this one's easy. This row right here, the first row, there's already 2 in the last box. So these 2 are out. So it has to be this one.
No,
good. See, it gives you an error. Yep, it gives you an error. So that's how you can also check yourself. So
the 2 go right down underneath that. Right underneath there's a 2.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's
where the 2 go. Yeah,
yes, because there's a 2 right here. So these 2 are out, and this 2 is out, and this 2 is out. So 2 has to go here. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4. We still need 5. We don't know that, and we still need.
Which way are you going?
It's gonna be a.
So it's all up to you. It's on how you want to tackle it. It's just what you see. So for 9.
If you go over one more, you go.
It's gonna be a
right there. Put the 9 right there.
Mm-hmm. So that means this has to be 5.
3.
And then at the top is gonna be 4 on the end.
Okay.
You said right here, 4 has to be right here.
Mm-hmm.
Why does it have to be right there?
The seat, because it's a 4 coming up from the last
this one.
The 4
yes.
Be
and it's right. The 4 coming up in this middle box.
Yeah, but it could be right here or right here. There's no other 4s, so we don't know that.
Yeah, I do.
How you know it
both can be here or here?
No, it may be 4 over there.
Okay, I'll tell you what. The 4 go on the 4 go on the 5 on the second box.
Yeah, you're
go
right.
Over. One more, Alex. Mm-hmm. Go down, Alex. Go over. That's where the 4, underneath the 5. That's where the 4 go.
Yeah, because there's a 4 right here that blocks
exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Right, the 4 go right there. Okay,
so
now
and look,
on the 3rd.
We have a 1
and the
4
go over top
here.
Of the 6. The 4 go over top of the 6 in the last corner. In the last corner, the 4 go right there. That's where the 4 go.
Good, because there's already 4 right here. So
exactly.
Yeah, there's only 1 more. There's only 1 more.
The 5 go up at the top next to
that's
the 3.
Oh, 8.
Go over. That's where the 5 go.
8, because there's only 1 more left. So you see the more of the puzzle is filled as we go through. So you just got to look for easy ones. So you need this row right here.
It'll get tricky on you and hard.
Right,
okay.
3 and 9.
Wrong.
Right,
where
so
are you at?
This has
go
to be 3.
Three.
Yes. Because there's 9 right here, and there has to be 9 right here then to finish the row.
Okay, for the.
Okay. Let's see. 7
1,
would be.
2, 3, 6.
7 would be at the top.
Right here? Where it's highlighted?
Yeah. Yeah, 7.
Yes, good job, Anne, because 7's right here and 7's right here. So 7 has to go right there. 1, 2, 3, 4. We need 5 and 8. So because
we're,
8 is here, 5 goes here.
We're not seeing anything. I'm just seeing Greer smiley face. I'm seeing Greer. That's
1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm not
so
seeing
we need
the puzzle.
3 and 4.
8 is
so
only.
I'm not seeing the puzzle, Alex. I'm not seeing the puzzle. This Dolores. I'm just seeing Greer.
Yeah. Make sure you hit the bottom right on your Dolores. Make sure you hit the bottom right square to view the whole skirt screen.
Yeah.
I'm not seeing
her. We'll get off. Make sure. Yeah, so as we keep going, this right here, let's go back here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 7. So 7 can go here. Yeah, we still need 2, 3, and 4. So 2 here, 2 here, 2. Two has to go here.
So we're making 8. Oh. In the wrong box, all of that.
Al, seriously, where's I'm only seeing you. How do I get back to the puzzle?
You have to hit the bottom right square, Dolores, where you see this. Just tap on it, please, and you'll be able to switch between the two.
I'm seeing me now. Sure.
So 1, 2. So we need 3 and 4. This is 3. This is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need 5. Well, we got 5. And we need 6 and 8. So because 8 is right here.
Yeah.
8 goes right here.
Up there and 6 at the bottom.
This one.
1, 2, 3, 4. So we need 6 and 8. So this has to be 8.
Going to
okay, yeah.
Oh, man. Seven
right here.
Yeah. 7.
Two has to go here because it's 2 right here.
And then 7 has to be
5 and 9.
And under the 2, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then this one here, it has to be 6.
Yeah, because that's the only number left.
2, 3. We need 5 and 8 in this column. So because there's 8 here, 5 goes here.
The bottom.
And then 1 and 9. So 9 is here. So 1. And then,
I just learned how to work to do that.
So you see that it's all about making each row and each column unique. It has to go 1 through 9, and in each of the boxes, it has to be 1 through 9 as well.
I got so many of these books, Alice. I take them with me. I go places. I play it online.
I used to do that years ago.
Yeah. So look, you can print this. You can do medium, and then you can do a hard one. So the hard one is extra uber hard. You probably have to do the candidates, because you see all we did, because this was easy, we just did the normal. But if you wanted to do candidates and see which ones are possible, then you would just mark that and then complete the puzzle. But yeah, they're going to add more of these. More minis, more Wordles, more Sudokus, more. This is called Spelling Bee. So I'm just going to showcase really quick how many words can you make with 7 letters. So you have to use the middle one. So tie, bam, or tied. That's 1.
Oh, the cheat.
Yeah. Or okay. You have to. So you have to use at least the center tile. You have to use the center tile at least once, but you can use as many letters as you want. So if I wanted to write gifted,
G-I-F-T, gift.
Oh, you spell the word.
You see all the selected words are already at the right. So let's see.
D-I-F-T.
What
else, another word?
What about deity?
F-I-T-E.
Okay, good. That was a good suggestion. D.
Oh wow, Andre.
What was the
there
good suggestion? There you go,
deity.
That's why back in the Haywood Ranch is the only
one. Hey, Andre.
Hey.
Let's see.
One more word.
What about tidy?
Yeah, so it's.
Did you do fidget?
You got T-Y-E, D-Y-E.
Fidgeted. Look, see, so you do as many words, and then you can, when you're done as many points or a certain amount of points, you're all done for the day.
All right.
So again, if you want to access any of the previous games or previous archives, just go ahead and if you like, pay that $5 a month subscription. So again, I'm not sure who has the TV on, just please make sure you turn it off before you join the meeting. But yeah, this is the New York Times crossword app. These are the games, more games, all the different packs available. So look, mini starter pack, there are 10 minis. You can just play, and they're all free to go. There are more free packs. So look, actual crosswords. You can play them. Different mini packs. You can try them out or buy individual packs for like $1 or so. But for the archives, you need, again, to subscribe and have pay that monthly subscription for the stats. You, again, you need that subscription and have an account. And then the leaderboard, so you can see all of who's finished whatever game the fastest. You can create an account. But as you can see, I don't have an account and I don't pay for the subscription. I could if I wanted to, if I were really, really, really into you know, these games, I would pay that $5 a month. It's worth it because, again, it's, you know, you use your brain, use your mind. You have to think logically about all of these different games and with words, with numbers, et cetera.
But some of these games, Alex, you can get free in your app store.
Yeah, so they're all initially free, but for Refind and this app in particular, there are extra components that require a subscription, but all of them are free to go. I have not paid a dime to do any of the things that I showed you today, so it's very accessible. But yeah, so now we're going to have an overview and discussion where I have some questions laid out. So if you could, again, either raise your hand or just answer one of these questions, I'd really appreciate it. So one is, what is new fact that you learned today? Two is, what apps are you interested in trying out and why? How can these apps improve your daily life? And in what ways will you embrace spring this year through the knowledge that we learned today? But before we get into the questions and comments, again, I had a lot of fun creating this presentation, and I hope you guys found a new app that you want to try. So you guys can unmute or raise your hand, but I'd love for you to either answer a question and or give some feedback. Who would like to go first?
I will.
Okay, go ahead, Violet.
I learned how to do Sudoku because I had tried and I could never get one done. So I learned how to do it today. So I'm going to be trying to work that on the iPad, because before I got so frustrated. I had a book. And I just put it in the trash because I could not finish one. I was this is impossible. I couldn't.
Okay.
That's what I learned.
I love hearing that. That's cool. So you see, again, game, you have the little question mark where it says how to play. So you can really read and try things out, and it's very forgiving. If you saw when you did the wrong number, it had a little dot saying, hey, there's an error. So it's very forgiving just to try things out.
And Alex, if you're doing it with a book, you need to use a pencil. Use an ink pen.
I tried many, many ways, but it didn't work.
Virtually, I think it's
Alex,
it's a very
ask me what did I learn from Sudoku. I can tell you what I learned. I learned to leave Sudoku alone. I learned that.
Right, because there are many different ways and avenues of doing these games and puzzles. So, you know, the collaboration, you know, you get to learn. So I really like that as well. So thank you, Andre.
Yeah, it was nice doing it with others.
Yes, and thank you, Violet. Anne, do you have would you like to answer a question or give feedback? You're muted, Anne.
Yes, I learned about the, I was concerned about, it's always interesting finding out how Chinese New Year, how the meteorologists, and when that started. So I learned that it started when it started and what the meaning of the new year is. So that was something I was interested in. And so thank you.
No problem, Anne. I'm glad you found that video useful. I've definitely learned some things myself. So yes, and I hope you enjoyed. Thank you.
I did, I really did.
All right, Diane, do you have a question?
No, yes, I do have a I'm going to tell you what I learned. I learned a lot today. Because I didn't realize that all that I'm learning is getting my mind to work more and more. Mm-hmm. And I like this. I'm going to pronounce it wrong, but you know what I mean. Saduko?
Yeah.
I like
Saduko,
that.
Saduko.
Yeah, Saduko.
Thinking on my nerves.
You know, just looking at the apps you have taught us, it's just mind-boggling because we learn so much every day.
Yeah.
And then I want to tell you about something I learned that I happen to be looking at. This flex card by the government, that's a scam. Yeah. What they want you to do is change insurances. And so don't buy into that $28 for free food, $2,800 for free food. That's a scam. So
I'm glad you told me because I was getting ready to get that down too.
No, don't buy into that. It's a scam.
Okay? I was looking at it.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for the information, Diane.
And if you want to know stuff, go on YouTube and ask YouTube about it. They're going to talk about it.
Yeah, YouTube or Google, or you know, use your iPad to figure things out and just check up on things that you may have a question about. So yes,
good advice. That's all I wanted to say, Alex. Thank you so much.
No problem. I hope you enjoy these apps.
I do.
All right. Next up is Louise. Hi, Louise. You want to answer one of these questions?
Well, yes. I
is Louise.
Found it very interesting. About the different interpretations of spring, when spring starts and everything. I thought it was very interesting. And also, Saduko, I used to play it years ago and I had stopped. And I was thinking, it was so nice playing it again. And the thing is, it also tells us when we're wrong that we don't do so much of the puzzle and then have to say, oh no, that's all wrong.
Oh well, that's why I love it myself, because it's very easy to go back and you know, make edits and be able to figure out things. So
yeah,
yes. I'm glad you liked it, Ruby. Thank you so much.
Thank you. You're welcome. Thank you so much for your presentation. I really enjoyed it, and working with others to figure out the puzzles was real fun too.
Oh yeah, no, really, I know you guys would like that, and just collaborating. So I was trying to, you know, hear everyone's input, and you know, especially you, Louise, figuring out that word. I would have never thought of duvet. So kudos to you.
Thank you.
Yes,
no
Alex.
Problem.
Yes, Alex. That's what I had wanted to comment on. I enjoyed us working together as a team, doing the group puzzle, and how we all interact with each other and accept each other. Answer whether it was right or wrong, but we all in it did it as a group and solved the problem. So to me, that was a lot of fun, you know, doing a group puzzle.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Dolores. Yeah. Definitely agree. Mm-hmm. So yes, thank you, Louise.
You're welcome.
As always, for attending. Thank you. Next up is Mr. Hawkins. Hi, Mr. Hawkins. How's it going?
Oh, it's going just fine. I normally use YouTube, but now I have WikiHow. Mm-hmm. You know, like when you have a project that you need to get done or you need to do, you can look it up. And if you can't do it yourself, you can look it up so that when you get someone to do it, you are knowledgeable on what has to be done.
Mm-hmm.
The other comment I like to make, a young lady suggested in the game, the New York game thing, if you find a game that you're playing and you like, and it may be a premium game, so they'll give you a few tries, go to your app and see if you can locate that game in the app. Because while we were doing the session, I went in and looked up Wordle. And Wordle, there's an app.
Yeah, it has. There's its own separate one for a lot of these, but it's nice how the New York Times crossword app brings them all together in one.
Right, but if you find, like I said, premium one, and they limit your time, Maybe you can also find it in the app and you can continue playing.
Yes, good suggestion. Because as you can see, some of the games, you can only play like that game, that day's game, right? So if you find a game that you really like and you want to play more, yeah, search in the app store, see if they have an app solely for that game. So like Sudoku, I know there's millions of Sudoku apps on the app store. So if you want to do more, you can download that app and then just get more from whatever you want to learn. So yes, thank you, Mr. Hawkins. That was great advice.
Have a nice day, everyone.
You too.
Thank you for attending.
Thank you.
Can I go to the bathroom?
Well, go ahead. Then you got permission.
Okay. Again, I'm not saying any particular names, but if you are in this Zoom session, you know, I would hope that you guys are focused and you don't have any background noise or any phones going off, so that way everyone is able to hear. I'm trying to limit the interruptions that we have. So please, if you don't have, you know, if you're not currently saying something or commenting, just please be mindful of if you're muted or not. Thank you. Next up is Denise Jackson. Hi, Denise.
Oh, hi. What started me liking the game Sudoku, you know,
Sudoku.
I used to always do fill-in books. You ever seen them? You could do the words.
Yes. Order. Oh, yes. On the grocery store at the checkout.
Yeah. And
that's where I started.
Yeah. And I saw this particular book. I'm like, well, what is that? So I started looking and I was reading it. I said, I don't know how to play this. It was puzzling me. I said, you know what? I'm going to learn this. So I started learning it. And I said, oh, it's not that bad. You know, I start liking it. But the fill-in, it's similar to this. And they have letters and they have numbers. Yeah, and y'all would like that too. But they don't have that on the apps though, do they? Do they
Again, they on the app store, there's millions and tons of different apps.
It comes on Mom's Meals. They have it on this.
Yes.
And I try to learn how to do it, and I'm out. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hi, Alex. I'm sorry.
But you can get
it. No, it's okay, Portia.
So that's good.
Okay.
That's when I start liking the game. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh, shoot. I love the game.
And yeah, now you can do it virtually.
Keep your mind sharp.
Yes, it certainly does. Because, you know, especially with the mini crossword that we did, a lot of them are current events. So when you're doing these crosswords, you know, you're learning fun facts for yourself. So that way, when you may hear it on TV or you're talking with someone, you're like, I already know that. Like, you know, so that way you can then, you know, share your knowledge, you know? So,
right. How it was with Jeopardy. I used to.
I still love Jeopardy. But yeah, like those games, all the word games, it really does help with, you know, how, you know, knowledgeable you are and how you can, you know, absorb information. So,
Wheel of Fortune too.
All of the game shows have an underlying thing you can learn from. So same thing with, you know, the apps. Just think of if you think of either apps on your iPad as a TV and the channel guide, you know, you guys will learn everything. that's why really the refined app, you know, I really implore you guys to try, because they come up with links especially for you. So if you're in the science field and you read all these different articles about science, you know, you'll be really informed on a certain topic.
Thank you so much.
Easy to install, because I installed them while we were talking.
Yeah. Wonderful. Thank you so
and
much.
That was interesting about plants having rhythms. And I was wondering with that, certain plants that do certain things, like say have medicinal properties, I wonder if they have similar rhythms.
Oh yeah, hey, look at that. So, you know, when you go on Google, you know, when you read the article, then you can Google the topic and learn more. But the article is kind of like a starting point. So once you get there, then you can go on Google and search and learn more. So yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Good, good, good.
It's really good.
Thank you. Next up is Ms. Deborah Edge. Go ahead and unmute, Ms. Deborah. You got a question for me?
Yes. I had sort of an off the topic question. I'm kind of hitting this.
Is that the one that you sent me in the chat, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay, yes. So for that app, I sent you a response. So for all of these, the majority of the trainings that we have, it's called the WTA DACL icon. So when you find this icon, again, WTA DACL, you can view a lot of the previous sessions that we've held, even some or a lot from 2021. So I would suggest you open that icon and look through all the video links that we have, okay?
Okay, that's very helpful. Thank you so much. I get so much out of this, but I'm juggling multiple programs. Thank God that DC offers all this stuff. So yes. I'm gonna take a class here. I'm gonna get to learn something there. And this was very informative today. Thanks so much for sharing.
Oh, no problem, Deb. I see your name all the time. So, and I know you've been with the program for a while. So I'm really happy to see you still be on, come on, advanced trainings. That's really impressive. So thank you so much for attending. And if you come on next Wednesday, just maybe let me know what you've used so far. Okay. I really like that.
All right.
Thank you. Anybody else have anything to say? Anyone right now? We have gone over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 apps together in 1 month, really. Because I remember I did the first few back before in the beginning of February. So anyone want to say what apps they enjoyed using, which ones they want to use, or who would like to say something?
Deborah Edge, Haynes had been up for a while. Deborah Edge.
I just answered her question.
Well, I like the TED and the art, the daily art. I like art and I found out a lot of things and I've shared it with my cousins. She is just amazed at what we could do. So I've enjoyed everything. I went on and found a lot of things on Black history. On one of those, I can't remember which app it is now, but I found a lot of things on Black history, and it's just been interesting. It gives you something to do.
Yes. I like WikiHow, Alex. WikiHow.
Yes. It's such a wonderful and easy app to access. So you can search for whatever you want to learn how to do, or you can just view a random article or see all your bookmarks and read all the featured articles and stuff. So it's a really easy way to Google, not really Google, but search on how to do stuff, you know? So that way you can just look it up yourself first. And, you know, it's always great to be independent. So I would look at this first about a particular topic. And then if you need additional help, at least you'll be informed a little bit about that particular topic. So that way when you ask for help, that way, again, you'll have that information where that way you can then decide the best outcome. So yes, Yvonne, I hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
Sylvia, did you have something to say?
Yes, I was gonna say, I love the WikiHow presentation you had today. And I missed some of your apps presentations. Do you have a list that you can send out so I can kind of download them and review them?
Sure, so there is a list. So all of the apps in the daily reminder, they have a general description of it, but let me go ahead and just type these in. You guys can see it all on you on the screen. All the apps that we went over, all of these can also be found in the daily reminder. So starting back in the beginning of February, if you go look through your emails, they have all the descriptions of all the acts starting in February for the Wednesdays. But I'm going ahead and putting them all in the chat. Really quick.
Thank you. Thank you.
Excuse me. Hello. Excuse me. Hello, everybody. Hi, Alex. Hi. Alex, which one of those apps is the one that you can show you to do things? Like it was somebody has suggested knitting. So then you brought up knitting.
Hi, Jackie. That was, yes.
That is hello. I've been here with you guys, but I've been on the phone. Sorry. So, but which one of those apps was that app?
It's the WikiHow. Right here.
What is it? Can you?
I'll show it right here. Here you go. WikiHow.
Okay. All right. Brilliant. Thank you.
Yeah, let me know how you use it, Jackie. And I said, let me know what you use it for and how it's helpful. I'd really love to hear that.
Sure will. And that was a very interesting what I was able to gather of that. I was taking call after call, working two phones here, but I was still with you guys too. And I thank everybody for showing up today. Thank you for being there.
Oh, no, thank you. You know, we all got, you know, a lot of things going on, especially in DC. So it's really great that, you know, you still are on and even though you're taking those phone calls. So again, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. So, you know, I put all the apps that we've got, well, that I've personally gone over with you guys in the chat. So we've gotten from Black developers, from female developers, podcast apps for spring. So every Wednesday I'll be showcasing something and you know, that relates to what we're going through, you know, in life. So again, it's always a pleasure. So yeah, anybody else have anything to say before we wrap up for today?
Yes. I like the WikiHow, how they slowly show you step by step that knitting. And so many people want to know how to knit and crochet, and they're trying to find somebody to show them. So that's a wonderful thing.
It is.
Right, look, I just hit random, and look, this one popped up: how to fix wrinkled leather car seats. So for all you have a car that want to learn how to do it, look, method one: smoothing minor wrinkles with the heat gun. And then once you're done with each step, you can mark it complete. And sometimes, again, they have more than one method. So if I go to the next method two, to ironing them out. So you can either iron out your creases or you can use a heat gun. So, and look, you, instead of going to the shop where you pay whatever, 20, 30, 40, whatever it is, you can do it for relatively cheap yourself, right?
Yeah, that's wonderful.
So you can look up anything, literally anything. It's there for you. So it's all about what you take advantage of it with.
Yeah.
But yeah, no problem. Again, thank you everyone for hopping on. It's always a pleasure to showcase these and always have fun creating them. I did this in about a day. So I had about a day to do it. So it's just fun. It's a game, just like the game that we went over. It's this kind of a game. You get it done, you move on to the next level, right?
Yes, yes.
and have
fun while you're doing it.
Of course.
You keep us young, Alex.
Absolutely.
Yes, thank you.
it's my pleasure. You got to stay in the present because, you know, especially in tech too, there's stuff that changes every day. So it's all about keeping up and, you know, staying with the program because no one likes to be left, you know, behind, right? So, you know, just by you guys hopping on today, you learn something new and something to share with your friends and your family, and you feel smarter. And nothing is as good as feeling really smart. So, you know, you know, be as boastful as you can because this is all for you guys. So.
And then you still feel like you can be a contribution into other people's lives, you know?
Yes.
Right, and not just because of, you know, how old you are, because anybody can be really insightful and intellectual. It's about the experience and what you know, actually gone through and seen. So everyone has their own unique take on life. So it's all about taking, you know, all the information that you get every day and thinking about how you can use it to help others. Because when you help others, you can help yourself.